everyone, and happy new year. Welcome to the Yonder Woman podcast. This is episode 56 and it is our first episode of 2017. Today is Wednesday, the 11th of January 2017, and my name is Melinda. I am known as Yonder Woman on Instagram and Ravelry. Please come and join us in the Ravelry group as well, Yonder Woman podcast. And all show notes for this episode can be found at www.yonderwoman.blogspot.com.au. So as I said, Happy New Year and welcome. It's been a few weeks, definitely a few weeks, about a month probably since we saw each other. I hope you had a lovely break, whether or not you celebrate any festivities such as Christmas or anything else at the end of the year. I hope you had a lovely time. Most people have time off from work. If you didn't, well done for what you were doing anyway. And just happy day. I hope you've had a lovely day so far, whatever you are doing. So I have had some time off work. I've got, being Wednesday today, I'm not at work, which is lovely. And I've got the rest of the week off as well, even better. So I've had a few days off work, sort of peppered here and there, but I have been in as well, which has been good, you know, break up the monotony a bit. Not really, it's fine, but whatever. I am very grateful to have a job, of course. So, but you know, it'd be nice to win lotto and not have to work as well. We'll keep buying tickets and we'll see what happens. But until then, I will continue to enjoy my paid holiday leave, and let's go and broach the subject because I've got lots to show you from what I've been doing in the last few weeks. So today's broach is this very gentlemanly looking koala wearing his lovely little bow tie, and that is from the Cute Australia range. Isn't that gorgeous? And that is designed by Sonia Britt Designs. Now, there's a lot of writing on here, so you can pause if you are very interested, but it's essentially saying that Sonia designs all her work herself. It's a cottage industry, and by purchasing, you are supporting local. So I think that's lovely. I got this when I was in Bendigo for the Australian Sheep and Wool Show earlier in the year, and it came in this gorgeous little pouch, and I just love it. Having that Australiana, it's also made out of recycled materials. There's bamboo around the outside. I think the bamboo is not recycled, but the bamboo is very sustainable because it's so fast growing. So that's it. This shirt is actually also made out of bamboo fiber. I wish you could feel it because it is amazing. It's not just me that thinks this. I got my stepson some bamboo t-shirts for his birthday and Christmas. Christmas because he asked for more. When he tried on the birthday one, he actually went and woke up his housemate at about 10:30 at night and said, "You have to feel my shirt." And the housemate was all groggy, but when he felt it, he sat up and went, "Oh my God, that's awesome." So yes, I'll put a link to the bamboo shirt shop as well, as well as a link to the store where I bought this and also Sonia Britt Designs, and you can have a look. Bit obsessed with bamboo products. If you talk to me about bamboo, I'll be on all day. So if you'd like to talk to me about bamboo, come and join in the conversation on the thread. Until then, no, I've got some finished objects to show you. This is the NYX hoodie. I was showing this to you as a work in progress towards the end of 2016, and it came out perfectly. So it's really hard to show you, but here's the hood. Now I will tell you why there's a stitch marker on there in a minute. So here's the hood. And then we've got two armholes, and it's sort of twisting in on itself, but it flows down each side, just sort of hangs down like that. So I couldn't be happier with this. This was a present for the teen, my stepdaughter, and she loves it. She has barely taken it off. It's only because one of the stitches has come loose, which is why there's a stitch marker. That's the only reason she's given it to me, because the stitch marker I've got on there is one that, oh, it's sort of gone through the hole. So let me just quickly wriggle it around so you can see it. It's a gorgeous moon, and this was given to me by lovely Deanne, who's Adiday Designs, when we met up in Canberra. Hi. And what the reason it's come undone, a stitch has come undone rather, is I did a three needle bind off to seam the hood, and I obviously missed one of the stitches. So it got blocked, it was worn two or three times before I noticed it, and then Sophie had it on and I saw there was a stitch making its way, and I was like, ah, luckily I had a stitch marker with me. And the cool thing with it being a moon, it actually kind of really suited it, like a black hooded outfit with a little moon on it. Not to get into witchcraft and scary things like that, but it just suited the style in a fun way. I've just realized it was inside out, so it's, you have this, I guess you could wear it any way you like, but the way I've done it is you have the stockinette on the outside. So great pattern. I knit it with, I think it was 10 millimeter needles for the hood and 12.75 millimeter, which I think I worked out was size 15 or 17, something like that. So very big needles. So I did not enjoy that part of the process because the yarn would slip off quite easily. It was a bit hard to, you know, manipulate the needles, but very worthwhile because the present is more than adored and it looks great on us. So here's some photos of the gorgeous girl herself wearing it on Christmas Day. I also finished a cat and an owl for Christmas. They were for YarnderNiece and YarnderNephew the second, so my niece and nephew on the other side of the family, and they loved them. So I wasn't sure how much they were going to enjoy them in comparison to their other presents, because we got them Pokemon and Minecraft presents. So I actually gave them the knitted items first, and even though they then got other presents, they still kept the knitted ones all together. And the little girl even said, "Oh, this must be my special present." It was very cute. So they went down very nicely. Now, you may recall I was also knitting a bat, and that nearly got finished, but not quite. The day before I had to hand it over, or give it, more to the point, was a few days after Christmas, and I was all set. I had to, you know, had my stuffing ready. I was getting seam. And then I realized that the wings part, I thought it was sort of one piece like that, but it turns out what I'd knit was like one little wedge, and I needed four wedges for the wings, and I realized it just wasn't going to happen. So I went out and bought a toy instead for the recipient, and the bat will now be given later in the year. So that's all good. I thought there's just no point stressing myself and staying up till 4 a.m. knitting pieces of a bat wing when the recipient is not going to mind. So nearly finished object, but not quite. I also handed out my two knit night shawls that I had made. You may recall I finished my third one, or I had nearly finished my third one in my last episode. That's finished now, but it's not blocked, so I'll show you later. But the two I had finished that I showed you were for my two aunties. So one was Yander Auntie, who has been on the podcast before and on Instagram. And the other one, Yander Auntie 2, I didn't actually get a photo of her wearing hers, but she did tell me several times in her short visit, because she doesn't live in Perth, how much she loved having a knitted item, how perfect the colours I had chosen were, and that when she had seen Yander Mum's knitted things, how jealous she'd been, so how happy she was now. So, and Yander Auntie the first has told me several times as well how much she loves it, and here's a cute photo of her wearing it on the day she received it. So my works in progress include my Christmas Eve cast on. Like many, many other people, I joined in with the lovely Danny of Little Bobbins Knits for her Christmas Eve cast on. And I used my self-dyed sock blank that I did in the colours and the name, Harley Quinn, from the Suicide Squad movie colours inspiration. And I chose to knit the pattern The Zigzagular Socks by Susie White of the Prairie Girls Knit and Spin. And this is what I have so far. They look fabulous. So the Zigzagular Sock pattern was developed by Susie as a way of being able to showcase variegated yarns in a way that would sort of make them pop a little bit more than plain stockinette. So you can see the back. Plain stockinette looks awesome as well with those colours. I think it turned out really nicely. But with the zigzag, just gives it an extra bit of pop, I think, which is fabulous. What's not so fabulous is that the stitch count I chose is not actually big enough for my foot. So this pattern comes in, it's a free pattern, you can get it on Ravelry, so excuse me while I pull out my printed version. And it tells you three sizes, 56, 64, and 72. So I went to 64 because that's my normal sock size anyway. But not having knit socks with cables before, as far as I can remember, And actually not having knit that many cables before full stop, I didn't realize quite how much cables pull in and make things narrower. So I think I would have been better off doing 72 because that might have brought it down a bit, or even maybe not even as much as 72, but just doing a few more. So I unfortunately cannot get these over my foot, my ankle. Oh yeah, my heel ankle part. So I thought, I didn't know if I wanted to make them for socks because the ones I've made for kids anyway are about 64 stitches because I usually do a tube sock. So what I've decided to do, and you can see here it's split, I've decided to make these into fingerless mitts. And for the fingerless mitt pattern I'm following, it's the one by Susan B. Anderson, I believe it is. And so to make the part that goes over your hand here, you just knit back and forth around this part and then join again in the round after leaving a hole for your thumb. So as you can see, I'm on my knitting back and forth part because there's a split there. And at first I thought, oh, I'll still be able to do the cables because I'll just be able to do them backwards. But then I realized, no, I'm sure there are much better knitters than me that could figure it out. But what I decided to do instead was just continue the purl stitches, because around the zigzags, you have purl stitches to really make them stand out. So the part over the thumb hole is just going to be plain purl. I haven't decided if I'll then pick up the cable pattern again, or if I'll just leave it going plain purl up. I'll see how it looks, whether it looks funny just having a gap and or not. It's hard to say. I don't know if these will be for me, possibly for the teen. I know she's been asking for some fingerless gloves, or mitts, I suppose. Actually, I think I've done it so the thumb hole goes. That really matters at this point, does it? There's no hole there. But that was the way I was going to have it, so that the cable part will be on the outside of your hand. So we shall see. I think they look pretty cool, so I might keep them for myself. We'll see. Anyway, very good fun. And the bag I've put them in is this lovely sort of silky one that Dubai Mel gave me. And lovely, simple. Now I must admit I haven't really worked on these much since Christmas Eve. What I have worked a little bit on is some extra face washes. So here's some black and red one, a plain red, red and purple, plain purple, purple, light purple and green, and purple and red striped. So I've had the face washes as something in my bag that is when I don't want to take anything too complicated, or when I just need something just in case. So I've got through some more of those. So most of these will be going to South Africa, to the charity collection that Sally Jane and Rachel of Pink Hair Girl Knits podcast put together. I think it was the purple and red one I knit while I was watching Rogue One, the new Star Wars film. And things went a bit weird over here, but I managed to join another colour while not really looking, and it was in the dark, so I was pleased by that. It's gone. I think I split through the yarn there, so I'll just sew that in properly when I weave in the ends. But yes, some more of those. I love this project. It is so much fun. I cast this on the 22nd of December, and other than the Christmas Eve cast on and then the face washes when I've been out and about, this has been the only thing that I've knit on. It's so wonderful. So this is the Find Your Fade shawl by Andrea Mowry, and I'm sure you have seen on Instagram that a lot of people have been knitting this. So it has 7 colours, although you can mix and match as you choose, but 7 is the standard. And the idea is that you incorporate a colour and fade through as you go. So I started off with this yarn here, up to here. This one is by The Unique Sheep, and the colorway is Doctors Without Borders, which is in reference to the charity Doctors Without Borders, or Médecins Sans Frontières. Don't listen to my terrible French pronunciation there. And I believe they set up that link due to the Yarn Harlot interaction, Stephanie Pell McPhee, because I know that's a charity she likes to support, and The Unique Sheep is a Canadian company. And so some of the money from the purchase of the colorway goes to Doctors Without Borders. Now, I've had this yarn for 7-8 years, so that may not be the case anymore, I'm not sure, but this is yarn that I've had in deep stash. And for some reason, I don't have the rest of the ball with me with all the other yarns. I don't know what I did with it, so I can't show you the rest of the ball, but it's sort of a charcoal gray, bright red, and a white. That's the three colors of the Doctors Without Borders logo. So that was the first one. Then I moved on here into another with reds and grays, and that was Ultron by Gnome Acres. And I do not have that tag, but this is the rest of the cake. So it's got some sparkle, red and gray, but a different shade of red. So I think that fade went quite nicely. And then from that one to here, we went to gray, red, and whitish, and the reds are sort of pinky sort of colors. And that is Sock Bunny Studios. And this colorway is such a funny name. It's called Running Without Scissors. Sorry, Running With Scissors. So you can kind of picture the red, why that might be there. And this yarn was a lovely gift, so thank you, you know who you are. Again, I've had this one for quite a while. So I really like the way that went from different shades of red into that. And then we introduced a bit of purple. So from here, we had this lovely light gray, lightish red, and you can see it fades through into this yarn, which is a speckle, which is somewhere in here. This one used up quite a lot, so there's not much left of this one. This is a Knit Pick speckle. This one is called Berry Smoothie Speckle. And yeah, as I said, there's not much left of that one. And I've just recently, here, these stripes, started this next color, which is gorgeous. So it's got some red speckles to tie it all in. It's got the light purple, the grayish white, and then this darker plum. And this is Jinx yarn. Again, some old stash, because this is a different label. Now Jinx has a little picture of herself with the blue hair. This color is Little Sister. So, as you can see, we've faded. We're going into the purples now. So my next one, I think, is going to be this one, which is also a Gnome Acres. This colorway is Decepticons. And yeah, I've reballed it. It's gone all weird. And then I think from there, my last color will be this one. Now, there is some blue in this one, but it's mostly purple. It's just reading very blue on the screen. This is Marigold Gen, and the colorway is Black Magic. So that's my Find Your Fade, and I just love this pattern. If you don't already have it, I highly recommend it, because you can have so much fun with the colors. This is all yarn I had in my stash, and I'm just so pleased the way it worked out. I just think it's fantastic the way it just fades through. And then I can't wait to see how the purples look as well. So it does get quite wide, but then after a little while, which end is it? Yeah, after a little while, the decreases stop on one side, so it's an asymmetrical, but then keep going on the other. So I can't say enough good things about this pattern. It's just so much fun. I can't wait to finish it so I can see how it all looks, but at the same time, then I'll be sad because it'll be finished. Maybe I will start another one. Who knows? But it's living in this awesome bag that Julia, Ninecrafty11, made me. Love, love, love. And it's great because it can fit all those skeins in there. And, oh, can't get enough. I was almost tempted not to record today, even though I really wanted to, just because I was like, I just want to keep knitting. So I think I will be getting back to that very soon. last year we had the 2016 year-long charity thread going, and we are definitely going to have that again this year. And you may have already noticed it is open in the Ravelry thread. This year there is an addition, so as well as being able to submit charity items that are knit or crocheted, I am also happy to accept posts regarding sewn items, as long as the items are for charity. So post in there. Same rules as last year, I'll be drawing a prize each quarter just from the same thread. So each time I'll draw it from the whole thread, not just things posted in that quarter. So I have to announce the final 2016 prize, and the prize we have is the Sight is Life ebook that was very generously donated to us by Ging Ging, who is going to send it to the winner. And the winner was post number 372, DG White, Denise from Seattle. Yay! So Denise, let me know when you have seen this, and then I will organise to have your prize sent to you. So thank you to everyone who entered. Of course, the prizes are not the point. Everyone is there just making things for charity because that's in their heart and they want to do that. So thank you to everyone who's putting that out there. Thank you to everyone who supported the charity knitters by cheering them on. And have a think about whether you might like to do something for charity this year with your crafting. And if you do, go and post about it, chat about it in the charity thread. I have some acquisitions. One I bought a while ago. I mentioned in my last episode, or maybe two episodes ago, that I went to Canberra, the Australian Capital Territory, for work. And when I was there, I found Lingcraft, which is sort of a chain store crafty place. And which we don't have in WA anymore, in Perth. And I found this spaghetti yarn, which is made from upcycled t-shirts. So it's 90% cotton, 10% acrylic. But it's, old t-shirts cut up into yarn. So this was only $10 Australian for a kilo. That's how it's measured, in a kilo, rather than in length. So I'm not sure how long the yarn keeps going. But I thought, why not? I will give it a try. I'm not sure what I'm going to make with it yet, but it's something for when I do. But the most exciting acquisition is something I won in a prize. So a few months ago, the lovely Kemper of Junk Yarn Podcast and Yarn Company ran a competition on Instagram to win a spot in her club for the holidays. So there was one for Halloween, Thanksgiving, and Christmas. And I was lucky enough to win. I was so excited. I've been wanting to try Kemper's yarn for so long, but just the exchange rate and shipping prices have not been in my favor. So this is just so wonderful and I'm so happy. So they're still in their plastics. I just couldn't bear to open them. So this one, look at that. Gorgeous. This one is called the Haynes Sisters. So Kemper for Junk Yarn, all the yarns are inspired by women, and so they're all named accordingly. It's that beautiful, look at the green poking through. So much fun. There was this one. Ooh. This one is called Coralie. Just love all those speckles. Yes. And this one. This one is Elsa, so you can see the frozen inspiration. And it's just beautiful. It just looks like ice. And so much love. So there you go. You can see colour inspired by women on the label there. Thank you so much again, Kemper. I cannot wait to knit these out. I wanted to keep them all nice to show everyone before I caked them, because I think there are going to be some socks in my future, but I can't decide which one. I thought I might keep this one to cast on in autumn here, because obviously autumn, opposite time of the year for the Southern Hemisphere, so it's only 3 months or so off till then. I say that, but Perth summer tends to drag out a bit, so it might be a bit longer. Having said that, quick weather update. We've had some really hot days, like up to nearly 40 degrees, which I think is about 102 Fahrenheit. But we've also had some cool days, and we had rain in December. That is unheard of. So yay, global warming. So other than that, let's not think about the sad part of that. In autumn, I might cast these on for my autumn socks. I actually have big plans for autumn. And as well as the yarn, I got these awesome stickers. They're puffy stickers. Wonder Woman, Batgirl, and Supergirl. The other day, I had the huge fortune to catch up and meet in person the lovely Grace, who hosts the Babbles Travelling Yarn podcast, and she's Vanna Willemiel on Instagram. We had such a fabulous time. So, as you may or may not know, Grace is from Ireland, but she's been travelling around Australia for the last almost year. And she was in Perth for a very short time, but we managed to find some time to meet up. And we had such a lovely time that time just went like that, and all of a sudden she had to go. So she's now in Tasmania, but I highly recommend you catching up on her podcast if you haven't already seen it. And I'm sure soon she will be showing us some lovely scenery from Tasmania, which is a great place. Tasmania is the island that's the component. If you have a Big Map of Australia, there's an island on the bottom. That's where Tasmania is. So, hi Grace, it's lovely to meet you. And look forward to your podcast. Speaking of which, Grace is the first host of the first month of the Wonders of the World Knit Along that is being overall hosted by Fatima of Knit Knacker podcast. So for the next 6 months, each month is going to focus on one continent of the world. So Grace is going to show us Australia and New Zealand. And then I think next month is South Africa, and we go over to see Sally Jane from Pink Hair Girl Knits, and then it goes around from there. So I'll put links to all that in the show notes. It'll be great fun. And there's a big list of designers and yarn dyers from both Australia and New Zealand in the thread. So it's good fun. I definitely plan to knit something. I just haven't decided yet. Possibly some fingerless mitts, because I've had a request for those for a gift. So this might be a good opportunity. But I haven't decided yet. And oh my goodness, the Find Your Fade Cow shawl is really drawing me in. But we shall see. So check out those. Some other knit-alongs while we're here that I'm planning on participating in. There's another Australian-themed one that's starting on the 26th of January. And I think that's going through to the end of April, so that's a longer one. And that one's being co-hosted by the lovely Shara of What Shara Made podcast, then also Hannah of Rose Hip Knits, and then I believe the other two are Yarn Adelaide Knits and Tam's Crafty Knits. So four lovely ladies getting involved in that one. So I'll link to all those groups in the show notes as well. Girl So Sheepy, lovely Tammy, is going to be having a year-long gift knit along. So getting your presents organised before the end of the year. On that note, as I said, that bat that I didn't finish was quite last minute, but it's not going to be now because look how prepared I am. Anyway, and there's a couple of podcasters that are running stash down knit-alongs all year. So there's lovely Shara again from What Shara Made, and then there's also the My Muddlings podcast. So again, links to all of those in the show notes if you're interested in starting your year off with some focus. So being a new year, it's a good time to have a look back what I did over the year and think about whether I achieved what I wanted to achieve. So the beginning of last year, I put down a whole lot of knitting goals on Ravelry. So I pulled them up today to have a look. So my first one was transform my wonderful stash into knitted items. I think that was the way I was positively phrasing knit more than I bring in. I didn't end up counting. Now, I was pretty good in not buying until I went to the Australian Sheep and Wool Show, where I kind of went a little nuts. But it was my first yarn festival, so I think it's fine. But I didn't end up counting how much I used. I would like to do that this year, where I write in the number of grams that I use for each project. So we'll see how it goes. You know, I'm not devastated that I didn't do it this year. It's more just of a geeky record keeping thing. I don't know. So we'll see. But that's my plan, is to take down note of how much I use. Fingers crossed. I have also written knit Christmas gnomes for my niece and nephew. I had quite forgotten I had decided to do that, so that one didn't happen. Work on Christmas birthday gifts throughout the year rather than right before the due date. Half and half, I'd say, for that one. Continue to be more monogamous, two projects at a time. I don't think that happened. I actually had a bit of a frogging session yesterday. I pulled out a whole lot of my works in progress that have been sitting on the needles for, you know, upwards of a year. and decided whether or not I was going to finish them. So some have been frogged, the yarn is going to be reused. Some I've decided to keep, but I might be altering what they are. For example, I had a pair of socks where I'd knitted quite long legs, and I've just decided they're a bit stiff for a sock, I think. They're knit out of, it's the yarn shop in Portland, and they do all the cool colours, and they have socks that rock, and it was this socks that rock. I've gone blank on the yarn company name. You're probably all yelling at me. Anyway, it was the Socks That Rock range, which is a bit plumper than a normal fingering. So I think I did knit them on a 2.5mm rather than a 2.25, but they're a bit stiff. And also I don't know if I can be bothered finishing them. They are going to become leg warmers because why not? So that's an example of my clear out. And that was quite cathartic because yesterday I was in a bit of a, you know, antsy mood. You know, sometimes you just get like that. So just ripping out stuff was actually quite good. Another goal I have was knit a blanket square each morning before going to work while I drink my coffee. Nope, that didn't happen. I don't know if I've knit on my blanket most of last year. I've actually decided that I'm not going to continue making that as a full blanket. I might just square it off, or, you know, have the edge flat so I've got a rectangle, and maybe just have it as a decorative piece to put at the end of the bed. I'm not sure because I'm just not feeling it anymore. I don't want to make a big blanket out of it. I am quite interested to make the, I think it's the 10 stitch blanket where you sort of do a square pinwheel shape going out. There's also the crochet blanket idea, which of course I would need to learn to crochet first. Lovely Denise sent me the crochet hook last year. I'm still going to use it, Denise, I promise. So yes, some other blanket maybe for this year. I also was going to knit 12 self-striping projects for the Stockinette Zombies Knit Along. I assume I knit some self-striping yarn last year, but I couldn't tell you. That one really didn't happen. But, you know, these are all just ideas and goals and things that were important or of interest to me at the time. No one's living or dying based on them, so it's going to be okay. So on that note, for this year, I don't know that I'm very interested in having a big list of goals. I know I want to make a lot of presents, but I do presents, you know, most of the time. But there's a few more because we're going to Japan later in the year. And I'd like to make some things for the people we're going to be staying with for part of the time. So I definitely want to have those as some gifts. Also, you know, birthday gifts, Mother's Day, things like that. I'll definitely still be making things along the way. But yeah, I don't know that I want to have a big list, because while not having achieved this list isn't stressing me out or anything like that, I just don't feel the need to have this big list of things to do. I'd rather just have a bit of an idea of things I want to accomplish, but they're not needs, and just float along and see how I feel. I think that's a better way of doing it for me at the moment. Part of all that is to do with my word for the year. You might have seen some other podcasts. I don't know, Helen of Curious Handmade has a word for the year. And definitely podcasters Brooke McCallery and Kelly Exeter, who are from Slow Home Podcast and Let It Be and Straight and Curly. I've mentioned them before. They're definitely, that's where I got the idea for the word of the year from in the first place. Mine is mindfulness for this year, and that to me is going to mean really thinking about what I'm doing, why I'm doing it, does it, you know, do things need to be done, not being mindless, so just going on the opposite of mindless, and really just living a better life in terms of, and by saying that I don't mean my life is bad so that it needs to be better, just better in the sense of mindfulness and happiness and things like that. So I have been reading a book, How to Live a Better Life by Jonathan Fields. That's really good. It's self-improvement, I suppose you'd call it, and it's all about that mindfulness and not just being in the rat race about things. I have got a compost bin now. I've planted some plants. These are all things I really want to focus on this year, is the compost bin, as well as that benefiting the garden. It, you know, stops so much going to landfill. Landfill and rubbish is such a huge problem worldwide. Did you know that if you put organic material such as veggie scraps in your landfill bin, it won't ever break down because it will get covered in so much other stuff, it won't get a breakdown. So by having a compost bin, that's going to break down. I don't know the science enough to know which is, whether it's aerobic or anaerobic releases. One does one, one does the other. The compost bin is the good one, we'll put it that way. So yeah, I'm really, really, really excited to be getting into some gardening. We planted some things on New Year's Eve and they're actually still alive. You know, my black thumb has not come out, which is great. We've actually, you know, mindful watering. I've been going out in the evenings in my bare feet, so I'm touching the grass, doing watering of all those plants. It's just lovely. It's really relaxing, almost meditative. That is something I definitely want to do every day this year, is start my day with some meditation. I use the Insight Timer app, which is free. It's got guided meditations. It's just got a timer. Highly, highly, highly recommend it as a way to just sort of center yourself before you start your day, which is really nice. And another book I am listening to, I'm only about halfway through, is called Move Your DNA, and I've completely forgotten the author's name, I'm sorry, so I'll put a link in. That's all about how movement is so important to our bodies, so as opposed to exercise. So I think most people are aware these days that if you sit down all day at your desk at work or whatever you're doing, if you just stay in one position all day, that cannot be counteracted just by doing some exercise at the end of the day. So it's looking about movement, how important that is to the body, because as I've discussed on this podcast before, exercise movement is not, or actually no, movement I am down with, you know, I get up and down from my desk a lot, but formal exercise, I just don't like it. And I need to find a way to enjoy it. I have been working on some things this year already, going for walks to, you know, picturesque places, going walks with someone. I've also been doing, you know, dancing where I just put music on and just move my body. So I am trying and I'm hoping this book will help me get over the line in terms of my mental block that I have with exercise. As I've talked about before, my mind is very firmly set on healthy eating now, not having preservatives, eating organic as much as I can, you know, huge uptake of the vegetables, all that sort of thing. But you know, as this book points out, you could be eating really healthy food, have perfect sleep pattern, which I don't know that many of us do anyway. But if you're not exercising, or more to the point, if you're not moving throughout the day and in different ways, then you're not healthy. So we will see. I will let you know how the rest of the book goes, but I am loving it so far. It's written really in an easygoing, friendly sort of a way, and it's lots of, you know, mind-blowing moments. One great example, this won't give anything away and it's not a copyrighted part. The author is talking about how orcas, killer whales, when they're in captivity, their dorsal fin often flops when they're in captivity. And that never happens in the wild. And what it's been found to be is that because in captivity, the orcas might have a big pool tank thing so they can move around, but they're only moving in one direction. They're not swimming straight. They've got a different amount of gravity because of, you know, they're in a pool, not in the deep ocean. So the forces pressing on that fin are not the same as when they're in the wild, and therefore it changes. And the analogy she gives is that the human body in modern day society, sitting down most of the time, having, you know, labor-saving devices, that's not the way our bodies have evolved, and therefore our bodies change and we get problems with our knees, problems with, you know, plaque buildup in our arteries, things like that. There's, you know, symptoms of being in captivity. So that was a fabulous analogy I found. And she has a lot of that throughout the book that I've listened to so far. And it really makes it easy to understand and apply to your own life. So yes, as you can tell, I'm really enjoying this book and I'm really finding it very eye-opening. So I will let you know how it goes and I'll put you a link if you are interested. And something that ties in both the gardening, eating healthy foods, is that I would like to have some pet chickens. And I won't get them till after summer because it's just too hot and we don't have the backyard set up yet for them. We don't have any trees. We're going to put a shade sail. But unless I can find a chicken coop for a really good price on the secondhand market, my plan is to build it myself. I'm going to look for some secondhand materials. So keep it cheap as well as reusing things, not having to buy new. And I'm going to build a chicken coop. And I think that will be a really interesting part of making because I've never really done that before. We've got all the equipment that we'd need, you know, drills and all that sort of thing. Later in the year, I will be doing that. I have long service leave this year, which at my company, once you've worked 10 years, which I will have later in the year, you get 3 months paid leave. So exciting. And so as part of that, I'm thinking that's when the chicken coop will happen. So I will definitely keep you updated on that. I'm very excited by this. Having said that, if I find one that's ready to go and it's a good price and it's making use of something someone has, I will definitely buy it and then I'll make something else. But more on that later. Thank you so much for joining me today. It's been lovely catching up with you. I've really missed you and I definitely am going to be more regular in my podcasting. Before I go, or rather just after I go, I do have some more video of our pet rats to show you. They all got a little Christmas gift of a knitted blanket from me. I'm grandma to the rats. They each got essentially a knitted face washer. That's what I made them out of, the cotton. And so you can see some video of them opening their presents. And then also one of some of them learning some tricks because the team is partway through training them. One of them is going to be doing walkies, which is walking on her hind legs. So you can see some of that training. I will put that right at the end so that if you are not interested in seeing rats, because I think it's one way or the other. Some people love it and some people really don't want to see it. And that is fine. We are all different and it's whatever we want to do. So the ratties will be coming up shortly after I sign off here, which I will do now. Thank you very much for joining me. Have a lovely day. I'll see you next time. And until then, happy crafting. Bye-bye. Peace. Coffee, tea, or Mimi?